name is Pastor L.A. Lopez, and we're truly blessed to have you here with us today. Today we are celebrating a wonderful, wonderful celebration, and that is particularly Father's Day. So to our fathers here today, those who are here, from Minister Mario and Tito Nino and Minister Romel, and everyone who's connected with us via Facebook Live, and those who will be watching this later on today, happy Father's Day. And most importantly, we greet our Father, who is our God, our King, who is the Father to the fatherless, and who has brought us from strength to strength. So happy Father's Day. Say that with me. Happy Father's Day. Praise God. Okay, so right now we'll go right into our message today. Okay? And our message, key text, is found in Hebrews 13, verse 5 to 7. Hebrews 13, verse 5 to 7. And I'd like us all to get our Bibles, our pens, and papers, and make sure that we have that verse particularly as we stand together and read it all together. That is Hebrews 13, verse 5 to 7. And if you are ready, kindly stand up, and we'll proclaim it all together. Okay, let's say it all together. Hebrews 13, verse 5 to 7. Say that again. Hebrews 13, verse 5 to 7. Make sure that your character is free from the love of money, being content with what you have. For he himself has said, I will never desert you, nor will I ever forsake you. So that we confidently say, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What will man do to me? Remember those who led you, who spoke the word of God to you, and considering the result of their conduct, imitate their faith. Let us pray. Lord Father, we come before you today humbled as you seek your face. Lord, right now we beg for your forgiveness for all our sins. Lord, we have failed so miserably, and we pray that right now, Lord, you may forgive us of all these sins as we plead that the blood of the Lamb be upon our lives and your Holy Spirit be upon us as we would truly, Lord God, stand victorious against this sin, Lord God, as we confess and truly, Lord God, nail these things at the foot of the cross. Right now, Lord, I come before you stating my nothingness. Wala po akong kahit pagmalaki, Panginoon, bagkus ang inyong kapangyarihan lang at ang inyong tawag sa aking buhay na aking pinangahawakan. That's why, Lord God, right now I pray that you may use me. Oh, brethren, Father, my preparation, make me so that your words, not mine, may move and change every single heart and turn them to repentance, that each person here may stand transformed, Lord God. Lord, I pray that no human vessel may be the focus of this message, but as you directly speak to every single person, that, Lord, today you may convict every single heart and turn them to repentance. Lord, I pray that you may grant us, Lord God, a spirit of contentment, an understanding, Lord Father, of being intentional in that contentment, as you, Lord God, are good, and as such, you know what's best for us. And so, Lord God, we trust in that best. We trust, Lord Father, in what you have in store. Lord, I pray that right now, Lord, you may change, Lord Father, each one of us, and I pray that we all may stand, Lord God, faithful and true to you, always obedient to you, desiring, Lord God, your presence, your light, your truth, and your love. In Jesus' name we pray. And all the saints said, amen and amen. You may all be seated. So our word of the week is found in the letter P. The letter P. And that is pretense. Pretense. Okay, pretense. Now, as the word is uttered, we can define that this is a very negative term. Pretense is the attempt to make something that is not the case appear to be true. Okay, pretense is making something that is not the case appear to be true. It is to put on an act, to feign, to fake, or simulate. It is a false and ambitious claim. In Tagalog, ang pretense ay translated as pagkukunwari. Pagkukunwari. Ito po ang problema ng marami. Ang pagkukunwari. Mahilig ang tao magkunwari. Making things as though they look like, pero in all reality, it's not the truth. Okay? There are many instances in the Bible kung saan ang pagkukunwari or pretenses have been released or has been seen. As Jacob clothed himself as Esau and pretended to be his brother. The same way as Laban, who promised Rachel's hand in marriage only to actually give Leah. Or wait, tama. Only to give Leah. Tamar upon facing Judah. All of these examples are bound by one term. Okay? When we talk about pretense, we're talking about deception. When we're talking about pretense, we're talking about deception. Thus, pretense is deception. The most abhorrent pretense is when one pretends to be holy, righteous, and godly when they really are not. Many claim to be saved, but they are not. The same manner that many ask forgiveness, show humility, yet are defiant within. These exude what we call a pretense. God knows what is really going on, and as such, be forewarned, lest you walk in a pretense. Okay? Proverbs 10, verse 9 is our key verse for this word of the week. And that is, whoever walks in integrity, walks securely. But he who makes his ways crooked will be found out. Okay? So that is our word of the week. So could you say it with me? What's the word of the week?
Pretense.
Okay, very good. Okay, so right now let's go right into our message. The message title we have today is simply put, Cultivate Intentional Contentment. Cultivate Intentional Contentment. Okay, or as my brother said earlier, C-I-C. Cultivate Intentional Contentment. Now, one of the best illustrations that I read about contentment was found in a December 1981 Reader's Digest. And if I may, I'd like to share the story to you. A Jewish man went to his rabbi. Okay? A Jewish man went to his rabbi and complained. Ang sabi niya, ang hirap ng buhay ko. Ang hirap-hirap ng buhay ko. Dahil nine kami na nasa isang kwarto lang naninirahan. So he's counting that kaya mahirap ang kanyang buhay dahil there are nine people in the same room with him and that is where they stay. There are nine of us living in one room. So ang sabi niya, what can I do? The rabbi answered, well, do you have a goat? May kambing ka ba? Ang sabi ng tao, oo, meron akong kambing. Ang gusto kong gawin mo ay dalhin mo yung kambing na yon sa loob ng kwarto mo, ng kwarto nyo, kung saan yung nine others with you. Ang sabi niya, ano? Bakit ko gagawin yun? Why would I bring a goat inside our house? Pero ang sabi ng rabbi, trust me, just do this. And then come back to me after a week. So ginawa ng tao. After 1 week, bumalik yung tao na yon. Ngayon, ang itsura na ay mabaho yung tao at marami ng eye bag at pagod na pagod at madumi ang kasuutan. Ang sabi niya, ginawa ka na ho, Rabbi. And, hindi na ho namin talaga kaya. Ang baho-baho ho nung kambing. Nandun po siya lagi po. Dun po siya nagdudumi. Dun po siya umiihi. Talagang dumi-dumi na ngayon po ng aming kwarto. Ang sabi ng rabbi, ngayon naman, alisin mo yung kambing na yun. At bumalik ka sa akin after 1 week. So, ginawa naman ng tao. Pagbalik ng tao, iba na yung outlook ng tao. Ngiti-ngiti na siya. Nasabi niya dun sa rabbi, okay na okay na kami. Bakit kayo okay na okay? Masay-masay na kaming nine na nakatira dun sa kwarto na yun kasi wala nang kambing. Okay? So the story is, and simply put, the lesson of the story is that contentment is not in your circumstance. It's not in your situation. But it's in your outlook. Amen? Amen. Contentment is in one's outlook. Contentment is a matter of perspective. It is not more so about circumstance, but in how we view things. For many, many may have so much and yet are not really truly content. While there are some people who have little, but are extremely content and secure and happy. Now understand that among God's people, contentment is not common. Jeremiah Burroughs, a Puritan preacher, captured the very essence of contentment by naming his book, the apt title, The Rare Jewel of Christian Contentment. Why? Because sa Kristiyano, ang pinakamahirap na ma-achieve ay pagiging kontento sa kung anong binigay sa atin. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Kaya it's a rarity. It's rare to have contentment. It's tough to find someone who's truly content with where they're at. And I'm not just talking about being content in such a way with financial or material things, but being content in your circumstance, being content where you're at this time, and being happy because you simply trust that God knows what's best for you. Amen?
Amen.
And so this is the movement here. Now let's take a look at this key text. Our key text says directly, being content with what you have. Now, this participle implies a command. It is not a suggestion uttering that you should be or is suggesting that you must be content, but it is a command to be content with what you have. This not just focuses on material things, like I said earlier, but in the situation you are in. In each circumstance, we must be content. Amen?
Amen.
We must be content. To grumble, ano ba ang grumble? Ano ang grumbling? Anyone? What is grumbling? Grumbling is when nagre-reklamo ka, naiinis ka, you show your displeasure. No? Grumbling is not just for children, but this actually could be seen with how we do things. Yung mga mahabang buntong hininga, yung mga naiinis na itsura, that's basically grumbling in every sense. Now, when a person grumbles about circumstance, we are basically challenging the love and goodness of our Heavenly Father. So when we grumble, we are challenging what God has done and His goodness and His love and His kindness to us. To be discontented implies that He has not provided us with what we need. So discontentment and grumbling can only be seen in the Bible through one specific thing, and that is the attitude of Israel toward God. The sin of Israel in the wilderness was simply put that. They were discontent and they grumbled. And because they were so discontent, they rebelled against God's goodness. Remember, saints, that God had just miraculously delivered them from slavery in Egypt. He was miraculously meeting their needs. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Yet they grumbled about their hardships. They grumbled and threatened to return back to Egypt. Kung saan kayo tinanggal na ng Diyos, spirit kang bumabalik. Amen?
Amen?
Dahil ayaw mong makita kung ano yung kanyang gustong gampanan at gawin. Gusto mo kung ano lang yung madali. Ayaw mong gawin kung ano yung mas mahirap. Why? Because you are not content with what God is giving you. Now, grumbling is the fruit of discontentment. Pag panay-reklamo po tayo, even sa tingin mo ay naghihinga ka lang na iyong saloobin, that is still grumbling in itself. You show discontent as to what God has allowed you to experience and to see. The exhortation of our text may stem from what the author said in Hebrews 10:34, where he reminded them that in the former days, in 10:32, you accepted joyfully the seizure of your property, knowing that you have for yourselves a better possession, a lasting one. But now they needed endurance, as found in 10:36 of Hebrews, that says, perhaps after their property has been unlawfully seized, anxiety has set in. Some of them now were focused on regaining their possession, no matter what was required. But pursuing material things can easily cross the line into loving them. And in the love of money or things, as in Hebrews 13 verse 5, it is opposed to the love of the brethren, which is in Hebrews 13:1. So the author calls them to contentment. Amen? Ang hinihiling ni ng author ni Hebrews ay kung ano ang tawag ng Diyos sa lahat ng kanyang mga anak. Be content. Be content. Okay? So that is the call. The call of the author is to contentment and to show them how to cultivate this rare but essential Christian Jew. So how do we cultivate contentment? Contentment is cultivated by first pulling out the weeds of greed in our life. Bakit ba hindi naging content ang isang tao ay dahil sa kanyang greed? Amen po ba?
Amen.
Now, like in a garden, if you are cultivating proper plants and so on and so forth, greed are the weeds. No? Yung masasamang gamo that chokes the good plants that you're trying to cultivate and to grow. Now, understand that in order to cultivate contentment, you have to weed out greed in your life by building up our lives on God and His promises. Many times, we lose sight of this crucial standpoint. Be it because of the cares of the day, our businesses, our busyness, and being downtrodden, disheartened, feeling as if we face things that, you know, that don't go our way. Pero dito nasusukat kung tunay nga ba tayong Kristiyano o nagkukunwari lang tayo. So kapag ang dinidinan po natin ay contentment, ang totoong Kristiyano ay lagi magiging contento sa kung ano ang binigay sa kanya ng Diyos. Maliit man yan o malaki. Pero ang hindi totoong Kristiyano ay laging gusto ng more. No? Hindi maging masaya sa kung ano yung meron siya. Ngayon, hindi ko sinasabi dito na huwag tayong mag-dream. Huwag tayong mangarap. Hindi po yun ang aking sinasabit. Ang sinasabit ko dito ay kung paano tayo mag-deal when it comes to our greed to gain more when in fact God has blessed us with what we already need. Contentment is where we ought to truly stand on and what we truly have to focus on. Dahil dito ho ng sukat, like I said earlier, ang ating pagiging Kristiyano. So how do we cultivate contentment? How do we cultivate contentment? Understand that God is a God of abundance. But it is our attitude that is in question here. And our attitude is supposed to be that we're always content with what God given. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Madali po tayong mabilis naman po na panghinaan ng loob. Lalo na kapag ang sinasabi nating to be content ay isa-isang bahay na sira-sira. Mahirap po maging contento dito. Mahirap maging contento kapag alam mo na ang iyong sapatos ay punit-punit na at alam mong mauhulog na lang, no? O nakalabas na yung may dila na. No, yung gumanga nga yung ating sapatos. Mahirap sabihin na tayo ay may kontento sa kapag lalo na kapag dumarating ang ating sweldo at hindi enough to make ends meet. Mahirap ko maging kontento ko doon. Pero hindi po yun ang sinasabi ko na contentment, no? Ang sinasabi yung contentment ay kahit na sa hirap man, sa difficulty, hindi ka nagagalit sa kung nasan ka, sa station mo.
Amen.
Amen po ba?
Amen.
Kasi kaya ka binibigyan noon, kaya ka nga, buti nga, meron pang enough para pangtusto sa iyong pangailangan. Buti nga, kahit na gumanga nga na yung sapatos, may sapatos ka pa rin. That's what I'm teaching today. The whole idea and attitude that we are facing. Contentment kasi is a matter of the heart and attitude. And contentment means that we are grateful regardless. Amen?
Amen.
We are grateful regardless. So sabihin po natin, dinalahan kayo ng pakbet. Pero walang chicharon yung pakbet. Maging kontento po kayo. Huwag kayong mag-demand na may hitcharon pang kasama yun. Ngayon, kung may hitcharon, praise God. Kung wala, magpasalamat kang may pakbet kang kinakain. Ngayon, tama po ba? Parang basically, ganun lang kasimple yung ating pinag-usapan ko. No? So how do we cultivate contentment? our number one thing here is by being intentionally content. Being intentionally content. Understand that contentment is not something that is automatic. Amen?
Amen.
Hindi to biglaan na lang na kaya mo sabihin na kontento ka sa buhay mo. And most of the time, yung mga tao nagsasabing, kontento naman ako sa buhay ko, sa kakasabi nila nun, hindi talaga sila kontento sa kanilang buhay. Kasi kung kailangan mo pang sabihin na kontento ka, kailangan mong paalala sa sarili mo kung gaano ka kontento, that means that you're not truly content. But being intentionally content is to be grateful, to be thankful, not grumbling over the feeling of being shortchanged, not grumbling over what we lack, but more so actually focusing on what we already have. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
So let's say you might not have the best job in the world, but at least you have a job. Amen. You may not have the best clothes in the world, but at least you have clothes. You may not live in the best neighborhood, but at least you actually have a house. Amen?
Amen.
Hindi maganda masyado ang kotse mo, at least meron ka pang panggasolina dun sa kotse na yon at kaya mong patakbuhin yung sasakyan na yon. The same way sa kahit anong bagay. Being content is not actually living in mediocrity or actually saying na hanggang doon na lang ang inabot ko, but more so, you being happy regardless of whether or not you rise up or you just stay as is. Intentionally being content is like a beautiful garden. It does not sprout at random. How many here in their houses have beautiful gardens? Ilan dito ang may beautiful garden sa kanilang bahay? O maayos na mga halaman? Okay? Paano nagkakaroon ng maayos na garden? Paano nagkakaroon ng maayos na halaman? Biglaan na lang ba nangyayari siya? Di ba most of the time, hindi. Talagang bubungkalin mo yung lupa, ayusin mo, papalitan mo to, mag-aalagaan mo hanggang sa yumabong siya. Ganon din po ang contentment. Hindi mo pwedeng expect na may contento ka na lang just as it is. Pero you have to truly stand intentional in making it so that you are content. So it does not grow deliberately. But we have to be deliberate in our aim to make it grow. Amen? Philippians 4:11 says, "Not that I speak from want, for I have learned to be content in whatever circumstance I am in." Or I am. Amen?
Yeah.
So that's basically it. So regardless kung masaya ka, malungkot ka, inis ka, be content. Amen?
Yeah.
Be content. So you have to be content. And contentment means that you trust in what? In the goodness of God. When you start being discontent, when you start getting angry and you start to grumble, then you are actually questioning whether God is going to do something great in your life. God is a God of breakthrough. God wants you to have overflowing blessing. Kaya nga lang, like the same as I was saying earlier, our attitude is the one in question here. And we should be right with God when it comes to our attitude. So, Paul learned, and so must we, that Christian contentment is defined directly as how John Owen wrote. John Owen, another Puritan pastor, who actually stated a proper definition to what contentment is. Now, contentment, as John Owen wrote, contentment is a gracious frame or disposition of mind, quiet and composed without, number one, complaining. So kung mahilig kang mag-complain about your life, then automatically, by point one, you are not content. You are what? Not without what? Complaining at God's providential disposal of our outward concerns. Kasi, remember this, when we are not content, we're actually unhappy with how God is running things in our life. Amen?
Amen.
Parang yung sa bahay, no? Kapag ang dinala ng tatay mo at ang inyong nabili lang ay isda, huwag kang magalit na isda lang ang ulam nyo. Maging masaya ka na meron pa kayong ulam.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. O sabihin natin, ang nakayanan lang ay ito. Huwag nang mag-isip pa ng more than that because you're actually questioning the providential disposal of the outward concern of the family. The same way with God.
Amen.
Okay? Amen po ba?
Amen.
Number two. To be content means that you are without all envy at the more prosperous conditions of others. Sabihin natin kaya nga hindi nakatulong ang social media sa maraming tao ngayon. Dahil sabihin natin may bagong damit ang kaibigan mo na ganito, o merong bagong, may bagong gamit ang iyong pinsan or something like that. Nakita mo, gusto mo na rin magkaroon ng same thing na yon. At hindi mo na tinantanan ng magulang mo, hindi mo na tinantanan ng sarili mo para bilihin yung particular na gamit na yon. And that is basically it, envious. Or yung mga kunwari, nakita natin nag-graduate ng maayos o yung maayos na nabuhay. Nakita niya sa Facebook. At sabihin mo, buti pa siya. Bakit, Lord, bakit ganun? Bakit ako? Hindi ako binibless ng tulad ng blessing sa kanya. That's basically envy. And when there is envy, there is discontent. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, the next one. Fear and anxiety, okay? Without fear or being anxious cares about future supplies. So meaning to say, yung buong movement of contentment is this. Kapag kinakabahan ka na kung saan ka kukuha ng pangkain nyo kinabukasan o pera sa pangailangan o para tususunan yung pangailangan, and that's already in itself discontentment. Why? Because ano ba ang next lang kapag yun ang inisip mo buong time? When you start worrying about that the whole time. Di ba may inis ka na, magagalit ka kung ano yung estado mo at this particular moment? So dahil sa lack na yun, nagkakaroon ka na ng questions toward God. Okay? Amen po ba?
Amen.
And the fourth one is desires and designs of those things which are more plentiful in condition that we are in and would supply us. So this is basically the movement of being content. Contentment is without any of the complaining, without any of the envy, without any of thinking as to what we fear, whether or not our needs are going to be met, or our desires are going to be given. The world around us seeks to make us feel discontented. Amen?
Amen.
The whole world around us is designed to tell us how much we lack. Amen?
Amen.
Yung morena ay pilit nagpapaputi. At yung maputi, pilit nagpapaka morena. Yung kulot, gustong magpatuwid. At yung tuwid naman ay gustong magpakulot. Yung kalbo ay gusto magkaroon ng buhok. At yung may buhok, gusto namang magpakalbo. That's basically the movement. Why? Dahil ang sikat, kung ano ang sikat, kung ano ang binibenta sa atin around us, no, ng billboards, TV, movies, catalogs, that is what we actually want to say, what we want to see. Naalala po ninyo ho, nung ang lahat ng sikat nung panahon, lahat ng lalaki, nakaspike po ang buhok, na kapag may butiki po na nahulog, automatic patay yung butiki. Lahat ng tao ganun. At kung hindi ka makagano'n, yung sabihin, kulot ang buhok mo, kaya dapat magpatuwid ka ng buhok para upagawa mo yun. Amen po ba?
Amen.
So around us, in this world we live in, we all have that feeling of discontentment. Dahil every commercial, every billboard, every ad, every catalog is designed to make us think that our happiness and our joy will be obtained if we get this item. Amen? If we have this. Imagine, no? Diba, kapag kunwari, nasa tindahan ka or nasa isa kang mall at may naisip kang bilhin, diba, iniisip mo, bakit mo bibilhin? Diba, most of the time, dahil makakapagpasaya sa'yo kahit papano. Mapapangiti ka kahit papano. Now, understand that this is not just talking about things that are tangible. But we're also talking about things that are abstract. Amen?
Amen.
Truth be told, if we are to base our happiness to what the world dictates, we would have lived and died never attaining happiness. Kung ang pagbabasihan natin, kung ano sinasabi sa ating mundo para magmasaya tayo, tayo ay mabuhay at mamamatay nang never natin nakamtan ang saya or ang joy or ang contentment in any front. Now, don't get me wrong, dear saints. It's not sinful to seek greater heights for one's family. Tama lang na i-hope mo ang best para sa iyong pamilya. The same way that it is not wrong to dream and to hope for a better tomorrow. In fact, the movement here is that kapag hindi mo yung ginawa, you're falling naman into another particular sin, which is sloth and lack of foresight. Ang sabi nga, hindi mo kasalanan na pinanganak kang mahirap. Pero pag namatay kang mahirap, kasalanan mo na yun.
Amen.
Hindi ko sinasabi na yun po ang gagawin natin, na kapag mahirap ka, may kontento kung nasan ka. Oo, may kontento ka, pero pilitin mo to look at it in such a way para maiangat mo ay iyong sarili.
Amen.
Pero hindi ko naman sinasabi na Diyosin mo ang pag-angat mo sa iyong sarili.
Amen.
Yun po nagiging problema. Kasi when a person desires to go up the ranks, go up to heights, then they start to forget who they are and how God prospered them and empowered them and blessed them. They start to forget where they came from. That is why they fail in the long run. There's nothing wrong with bettering yourself and your station, pero it should come from a deeper meaning. Amen? God has given us the ability to produce wealth. God is a multiplier. Amen? He wants to bless us, pero he wants to hear from us the purpose of why we want to be blessed. It's not enough that you just want to be blessed. Many people ask for blessings every single day. The difference is that you need to understand why you want to be blessed. Amen?
Amen.
Why would God grant you this? Paano kung baka nagtanong ka sa Diyos, Lord, bigyan niyo po ako ng limpak-limpak na salapi. I assure you, kahit lumakad ka dito hanggang sa EDSA, hindi mauhulog galing sa langit ang limpak-limpak na salapi. Why? Because that's not how God works. Nor is it that it will actually bring about blessing to you. It might even be mitsa sa buhay mo. Narinig po rin yung mga tao na nanalo ng lotto or sweepstakes, nalaman na sila yung nanalo. So, inabangan sila at naging mitsa pa ng buhay nila yung kanilang napalanunan. Dear saints, dapat mas malalim ang pinaghuhugutan ng blessing na inihingi natin. And that is to be a blessing to others.
Amen. Amen.
To be a blessing to others. It should be deeper, much more deeper than making ends meet. Much more deeper than obtaining wealth, than rising in fame and popularity. It should mean more than getting our name out there and seeking greater heights. But it should mean that we are truly binding and cleaving ourselves to God's call to greatness. Now, what is God's call to greatness? To serve. Amen?
Amen?
To serve. Because blessings should come directly because of God's redemptive purpose.
Amen?
Amen?
God wants to redeem people in the world. That's why He's gonna bless people who serve Him para ipalaganap ang mabuting balita at para malaman ng lahat na may isang mabuting Diyos, may isang mapagmahal na Diyos na tinatawag tayo para tunay na lumapit sa Kanya. Amen po ba?
Amen.
So, greatness means the greatest good for all. Amen?
Amen?
To serve others as He rise up to serve our King. So, it boils down to why we do what we do. Amen? Yun naman po yung question natin. Why do we do what we do? Bakit tayo... Why are we dreaming? Why are we hoping? Why are we praying? Why do we want to raise up from our station? Why do we want to go forward? Many times, dear saints, maraming tao matino ang plano when they're actually sharing it and they're hoping and praying as starry-eyed dreamers. But in the end, since they lose sight of why they do what they do. So it all boils down to that. And that's a question we must ask ourselves each day, since the battle for contentment is ongoing. Amen? It's a daily struggle. The truth is, you might be content with God now, but tomorrow is a different story. Amen?
Amen?
You might be content with God in this specific time because you're in church, but once you leave church, the story becomes different. Amen?
Amen?
So, it should be that we do not lose sight of our contentment and focus instead on the lack, but you must always remember the goodness of God and what He has bestowed. Only those who are content in Christ are able to rise up from their station. Only those who can say they love what they do, no matter their hardships, can and will be prospered to something even greater. That is what God actually wants us to have. That is why contentment is very important. Amen?
Amen.
For unless you're already grateful to God for what you have, you will stay in your station, for that will be your only success, breakthrough, and fruition. Dahil ang attitude ang ating problema. I preach this to myself as I share this all to you. We cannot hope for the best if we are not the best. Amen?
Amen.
To be the best means to rid ourselves of our very worst. Thus, we must exude intentional contentment. Intentional contentment means you don't complain or grumble. You are genuinely happy for other success. You fear not what tomorrow brings, nor fret as to the conditions you must meet to obtain your desires. For in Hebrews 13, verse 6, it says here, so that we confidently say, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid, what will man do to me? This confidence can only be exuded if we stand intentional, content in what God has bestowed, as we trust Him that He knows what is best, and if we rise in obedience and righteousness. God will bless us with the help we need, never fearing our circumstance or what tomorrow may bring, but trusting that God's best is yet to come. Amen?
Amen.
Now, what is number two of this? Number two is we actually win and cultivate contentment, or intentionally cultivate contentment, by destroying greed at the root. Destroying greed at the root. Make sure that your character or way of life is free from the love of money. Notice here the term. Understand that money is not the root of all evil, but the love of money is the root of all evil. The Bible presents greed as a terrible sin, equal to idolatry. In Ephesians 5, verse 5, it says, For of this you can be sure, no immoral, impure, or greedy person, such a person is an idolater, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Now, why is greed equal to idolatry, even equal to what? To impurity. Why is that? Because greed feeds off pride. Kapag ma-pride kang tao, you are greedy. And if you are greedy, you are prideful. Amen?
Amen?
With that comes the worship of ourselves. Kaya nga tayo greedy dahil we think much on what we want, on what we desire to obtain, and we lose sight of what we must do for others. We just think of what we can obtain for us. Amen?
Amen.
And so, we recognize our strength to obtain what we desire, instead of recognizing our weakness, our wretchedness, and the lack that we have, and the sufficiency of God's grace to turn our failings to successes. Amen?
Amen.
To empower us in humility. Understand that greed ruined several people. It ruined Balaam in 2 Peter 2:15, Achan in Joshua 7, verse 1, Elijah's servant Gehazi in 2 Kings 5:20-27. Judas Iscariot in John 12, verse 6. Ananias and Sapphira in Acts 5, 1-10. And Felix in Acts 24, 26. And even to this day and age, we see the faithful become faithless. Families broken. Friendships torn. churches abandon, all in the name of greed. Jesus states, worries and riches and the pleasures of life as the thorns that choke out the word from bearing fruit, as found in Luke 8:14. He warned in Luke 12:15, beware and be on guard against every form of greed, for not even when one has an abundance does his life consist of his possessions. He went on to tell the parable of the rich young fool who planned to build bigger barns to hold his wealth, but died that night. He concluded in Luke 12:21, so is the man who stores up his treasures for himself and is not rich toward God. So what do I mean by being rich toward God? By being truly content in what God has given and truly cultivating what He has already bestowed to us. Amen, Puba?
Amen.
So greed or the love of money is a dangerous weed that keeps popping up in everyone's life. You can pull it one day, but behold, the next day it will still be there and has grown to a substantial amount. You will not enjoy God's contentment unless you keep weeding. Amen? Unless you keep weeding. So how must we destroy greed? I think that's the focal point here. How do we destroy greed? The first point is to acknowledge, to know and acknowledge that all we have, all we are, all we will ever be is because of God. Amen?
Amen.
So yun po ang unang punto para paglabanan natin ang greed. Kailangan natin alalahanin na kahit tayo ay napakataas na o tayo ay hindi pa rin gano'ng kanaas at tuktok, no, ng ladder of success, everything that we are, everything that we will be, everything that we are going to be is because of God.
Amen.
Amen. And all things are for Him. Psalm 24 verse 1 states, the earth is the Lord's and all it contains. So lahat po ng bagay ay sa ating Panginoon. Once we have done this, greed has lost a foothold in our hearts and in our life. All we are is His. So yun pong ating alalahanin. Lahat ng sa atin, lahat tayo, buong sarili natin ay para dapat sa ating Panginoon. Amen?
Amen.
All of us are His. What is that? Our time, our resources, our successes, our accomplishments are all God's. Thus we know that we are risen up not because of our talents or skill, but through Christ alone. Amen, Puba?
Amen.
Amen, Puba?
Amen.
Okay. The next one, and the second one. Put your treasure where your heart is. Put your treasure where your heart is. This comes back to the query, why we do what we do. What do you treasure above all else? Okay? What do we treasure about all else? Alam po ninyo, malalaman natin, madaling sagutin kasi ngayon kung ating treasure, ano ba treasure natin sa buong buhay natin? Madaling sagutin ngayon sabihin si God. Pero in all reality, mga kapatid, kung ano ang unang-una mong titignan, kung ano ang unang-una mong gagawin pag-ising mo, yun yung treasure mo. That's basically it. Kaya importante mga kapatid na kasakiman ay labanan sa pagdulog maya't maya sa Diyos. And be reminded why we were created by God in the first place. And that is what? We are created by God for His glory. Amen po ba?
Amen.
And so, what you treasure is where your heart is. Amen?
Amen.
So, kunwari, kung ano man ang iyong inuuna, yun yung tinetreasure mo above all else. Okay? So, kung ang tinetreasure mo ay ang Diyos, then you should do all things for God. All you must for God, no matter the what, no matter the cost. You will speak Christ, you will sing Christ in all and everything because He is your treasure. He is your heart. Amen?
Amen.
The third one is to live for eternity. Live for eternity. Greatness is by serving others. Amen? Ang problema ng maraming tao, ating what we live for is the next day. Or we live for whatever we can actually obtain the next week and the week after that and so on and so forth. But what God is calling us to do in order to battle greed is to live for eternity. Live for eternity. Greatness is by serving others. Greed seeks to serve self since it is short-sighted. Remember, dear saint, kung short-sighted tayo, then all we see is greed. Kaya ang importante po natin, na dapat natin laging alalahanin na ang end point ng lahat ng bagay natin gagampanan ay hindi kung ano man ang makakamta natin sa mundong ito. Pero kung ano po ang ating magagawa para paluguran, papurihan ang ating Panginoon na siya ang end point. We are just passing through in this life. We are transient beings just passing through. The real life is after we have transcended this one. And so what you do here actually shows what you will do when you go into eternity. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Kaya nga, it's important that we don't just become so short-sighted and think as to what we have to obtain, but we have to be seeking what God desires us to accomplish and do. Amen?
Amen.
Dahil mga kapat, hindi tayo dapat nabuhay para sa ating sarili lang. Para lang sa ating kapakanan. But instead, we should shine kingdom mentality. Living a life of service to God and to the brethren. Thus, you give more, not just monetary or material things, but you give your time. You offer your life. You give your heart. You give your all. Huwag tutulad mga kapatid sa mundo na lahat na lang ay pinagdamot dahil ang gusto na nalang makita na namamayagpag ay ang kanilang sarili or ang kanilang pambato. But be a rarity. Give. Amen?
Amen.
Give. By doing so, we are able to cultivate intentional contentment by our last and final point. And that is, number three, is building our life on God and His promise. Building our life on God and His promise. Hebrews 13 verse 5 to 7, which is our key verse today, says, make sure that your character is free from the love of money, being content with what you have, for He Himself had said, I will never desert you, nor will I ever forsake you. So that we confidently say, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What will man do to me? Remember those who led you, who spoke the word of God to you, and considering the result of their conduct, imitate their faith. The Lord is our helper. Amen, Buba?
Amen.
He has promised never to leave us, nor forsake us. Now we've heard this countless times over. Amen? Every time na merong problema, ang automat na sabihin ng kahit sinong Kristiyano, alalahanin mo kapatid, God will never leave you nor forsake you. Madaling sabihin po ito at madaling paniwalaan po ito. Ang ayaw nating laging sambitin ay yung requirement to the promise. Amen?
Amen.
Kasi mga kapatid, sa Biblia at kahit saan actually, hindi nangyayari na merong isang promise na walang requirement. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Hindi ka pwedeng mag-promise ng walang requirement. Amen?
Amen.
Parang kumbaga, you cannot be promised a promotion if you don't do your work well.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
Okay? You can't be promised tax returns if you don't pay your taxes. Amen?
Amen.
That's just a basic principle, and I know that logic is not really taught anymore in many institutions now. But the usage of that is simply put, if you do this, you will get this. That's basically it. Amen?
Amen.
Paano kung bagay yung mga nagbibenta ng credit card sa'yo sa mall? No? Makakuha ka ng popcorn or ng payong kung mag-sign up ka dito. That's basically it. Okay? Now, walang promise na nabibigay sa'yo simply because it's just a promise. Amen?
Amen.
The same way here, biblically. You cannot say that the Lord will always be with you and He'll always guide you and always protect you if you don't stand by the requirement. Amen? And the requirement is what? You have to quell greed in your life. You want God to be with you? quell greed in your life. Amen?
Amen.
You don't want God to be with you? Be greedy. That's as basic a principle as I can actually utter. Okay? What do we have to do to have God in us, to have God as our helper? Be faithful. Why? Halata po ninyo dun sa verse, babalik tayo para sambitin po yun, sa verse 7. Tingnan nga natin po yun. Sa verse 7. Halata niya, after sinabi, the Lord is my helper. And after sinabi na, the Lord will never leave you, nor will I forsake you, may sinabi ho dito after. Ang sabi sa verse 7, remember those who led you, who spoke the word of God to you. So, hindi automatic yun na porket nabasa mo yung never leave you nor forsake you, automatic, yes, he won't leave me. You have to worry about whether or not ikaw ba'y dapat na hindi i-forsake. Ikaw ba'y dapat hindi iwanan. Kasi ang dapat hindi iwanan, hindi i-forsake, ay yung taong tapat sa Diyos. Amen po ba?
Amen.
That's why it's important to remember who led you, who spoke the word of God to you, and consider the result of their conduct. Hindi mo lang susundan sila blindly. Na porket, ay sila nagturo sa akin, so kahit anong sabihin nila o gawin nila, yun yung tama. Hindi. It's to what? To consider the result of their conduct. And if it is a good result, imitate their faith.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And that is the key there. You want to have that hope. You want to have that contentment in your life. You want to defeat pride. You have to truly cleave to the word of God here to understand that God will not forsake you if you stand true, faithful to Him, and quell greed in your life. Building our life on God means to cleave to Him. Amen? Amen. To obey His word and to seek Him moment by moment. When we say we are building our life, mga kapatid, when we say we are building our life, hindi ibig sabihin na naghulog ka para sa bahay mong bibilihin. O nakahulog ka sa iyong SSS at pag-ibig. That's not building your life. Everyone does that. Building your life means you're building up to God. Amen?
Amen.
How do you do that? By truly cleaving to the King, by worshiping Him, and living a life of praise to Him. Only then can we find true contentment. If you seek God, you will be content. At dahil contento ka sa kung nasan ka, sa kabubuksan ng Diyos ang pintuan para sa iyo for greater things. Amen? That's the promise. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Dahil masaya ka sa kung anong binigay sa iyo ng Diyos, at pinagyabo mo ko ng binigay sa inyo ng Diyos, then automatically, He will open the door for you to see greater fruition and greater hope. Amen?
Amen.
A.W. Tozer once said, the man who has God for his treasure has all things in one.
Amen.
Could you say that again with me? The man who has God for his treasure has all things in one. Kaya marami po sa atin ang tila nakakaramdam ng kakulangan. Dahil hindi pa ang Diyos ang ating tinatangi. Amen?
Amen.
Kaya kapag ang buhay mo, ang feeling mo may kulang, hindi na ibig sabihin na dapat may bilhin kang panibago. Hindi na ibig sabihin na dapat meron kang habuling panibago. Amen?
Amen?
Sa mga singles dito, sa mga youths dito, kapag may kulang ang buhay ninyo, hindi na ibig sabihin maghanap ka ng love life. Ang hanapin mo, si God.
Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
That's the key there. Many are lost in the circus of the world, drawn by the sights and sounds, the empty pleasures and meaningless pursuits, that they end up empty. Halata po ninyo, maraming tao na lahat ay nasa kanila, pero walang kahit anong meron sila. Amen?
Amen?
Many people have the world at their feet, but nothing. Do not be that type of person who has seen the world and yet did not see nor understand what he was actually looking for and seeing. Understand that we can only truly enjoy successes in our life because of God. Kaya nga kapag Kristiyano ka, even the smallest of success becomes such a joy and a celebration to you. Amen?
Amen.
Even how tiny you actually get up there, you succeed, you rise up, even in the smallest way. You are so happy, you're so joyful, you think that you just won everything in the entire world. And yet truly, it is so. Why? Because you know that all your treasure is in one. And that is because you have God as your treasure above all else. Amen?
Amen.
So, this all goes back to the understanding that to be content means that you are not hoping for the greatest of good for you, but because you desire the greatest of good for others. That your desire to raise your station is because of the redemptive purpose it can do upon your fruition and success. We don't do it for acclaim and honor, but we do it to shine God's light to all. For in our success, the gospel is preached. Amen?
Amen.
Our victory is being in the center of God's will. Amen?
Amen.
So it's very important that we cleave to that truth. That we have accomplished our purpose and we rise up to the call of greatness to serve others and to serve, honor, and praise our King. Let us all pray. Lord Father, we come before you grateful as you worship you, Lord God, and truly cleave to you. Lord God, we are so grateful for every day, for the breath that we have in our lungs, for the life that we have, Lord Father, here, for the brethren that we celebrate each Sunday with, for every single person you have granted unto us to bless, to care for, to pray, to love, to encourage, and even to correct. Lord God, we are grateful for everything that you have bestowed because all good gifts are from you, our King. And as such, we stand today, Lord God, humbled as we cry to you and repent for the moments when we fail to be grateful, for the moments when we sought more simply because we wanted more for us. Lord God, today I pray that you may change our hearts and our attitude to know fully well why we do what we do. That, Lord, in our contentment, you may open the doors to fruition and success, not because we desire acclamation, not because we desire fame and admiration, but, Lord, because we desire, Lord God, to accomplish what you sent us to accomplish. To proclaim your word and to proclaim your redemptive purpose. Lord God, the question why we do what we do is truly the query that each one of us have to ask ourselves, especially in the onslaught of discontentment, especially in the onslaught of greed, of pride. Lord, we pray that right now you may move in our lives, move in our hearts, change us, our King. And make me so, Lord, that we may live a life of greatness. A greatness that is defined in you as to serve one another in the faith. And to serve you, our King. Lord, Father, it is not coincidence that today we celebrate Father's Day. As we stand as a body of believers grateful for every single blessing that you have given. Great is the measure of your love, O God. And so, Lord God, right now I pray that our response to your love and your goodness should be our faithfulness and our love to you, our King. Lord, I pray you may guide us today as we worship you, as we celebrate you, as we lift you up and intentionally walk in contentment. Walk, Lord God, in the understanding that you have our best as you ascribe your best, and we walk to be the best of people, not by our might or power, but by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Prayer of a righteous man.